Henry 190, just verifying, sir. You're going to be 7060, which is the first one, 12.
Sort of in the shoulder.
Yeah.
And then make connections.
That didn't hurt at all.
Blood area.
That never hurt anyone in our entire life. Come on out. That was worth it. That was really great taking us. We've never punched someone or hurt someone or thrust someone in our entire life. Ever. I've never thrown a punch on someone in my entire life. Ever. That really, that's really called for.
That's what
concerns me. That's never done before. I've never had before. What I'm saying is that it's necessary. I'm a normally peaceful person. But when you go for 90 days with people harassing you, hacking your phone, I can't get into any of my people now. I know, because it's not a one of the
I just shot him point blank, and then I made connection in his lower back, and then he finally fell to the ground. He was grabbing onto a fence post and, like, completely tense up. We could not get him free.
Right there.
he's to the, he's got, he's to the,
yesterday he was like, no foot pursuit, no foot pursuit, so we get no foot pursuit.
He don't mean it. He says it. He,
I feel like he has the worst luck, too.
I'm going to try 700.
That was his, like, thing every night. Like, all right, let's go out there, no foot pursuit, no foot pursuit, no fight, you know, and just be like,
yeah, I went down to the butt, and I was sitting there, and it still wouldn't take him down. So.
I think he's already trying to eat.
Your incident has been updated.
Hey.
You got HIV.
I know. He took care of that dose test.
Yeah, no, he's not. He just said he didn't. Yeah, he's just taking pills for it. We got multiple calls over here about someone high on drugs, attempting to get in vehicles, yelling and screaming at the vehicles and everything like that. He was possibly high on drugs. We couldn't find him in the check area over here. This person came out with the exact same description of the same person doing the exact same thing over here. So we come in here, we pull into the apartment, and we see him on the other side of the fence right here, walking back towards this way. I back out of here. Cadena stops right here and goes out on him, tells him to turn around, put his hands behind his back. He starts to turn around, put his hands behind his back. And then I park my car, start to walk up towards him. At that time, the male starts pulling away, actively resisting. We try to put him on the fence. He ends up latching onto the fence with everything he has. Three or four officers are on him, pull him, trying to pry his arms off the fence, try to pull him off to take him, put his hands behind his back. We weren't able to do it because he was obviously on some sort of drug, and he had pretty incredible strength. I attempted to leg sweep him a couple times to try to get him to go to the ground, and I couldn't do it. So at that point, I told him I was going to tase him. They said everybody danced like tase him. So I stepped back. I shot him pretty much at point blank in the shoulder, and then made the third contact in his lower back. He started to tense up a little bit. It caused neuromuscular incapacitation, but he was still fighting through it. I went lower down to the leg and locked it up even more, and then he finally was able to go to the ground. I believe I had to cycle it again because he was still actively fighting through the tasing and not putting his hands behind his back. Eventually, other officer showed up, and we were able to all get his hands behind his back at that point. So.
Okay. Any strikes that you saw?
I didn't deliver any. I tried to do the leg sweep and take him to the ground, and we couldn't get him off the fence. He had both his hands onto the fence, completely pried.
Any injuries to you?
No.
Freaking out.
What?
But I'm freaking out.
Freaking out?
Yeah. I hate having to use it.
Hey, what size are your dolls?
14.
Yeah, I had to order them offline, and because of that, I had to pay more for them, but I needed some sort of
cover.
Yeah, I know, it's rough. I used to wear, or I tried the Under Armours. I don't know if those are Under Armours. Under Armours are horrible because it's so tight on the top, so that's why I wouldn't get them. But yeah, trying to find a size 14 is like...
Did you order someone that length?
I don't remember where I got them from.
Sold out.
Yeah. I think I actually got them from REI.
Well, I'm 14, but I was going to try a 13.
Yeah.
No. Not for 14. Yeah, it was a 150 or something like that. But yeah, I mean, well, it's because only a couple of places would carry them, and then when they do carry them, they charge you full price. I can't do the Under Armour ones, man. I mean, those damn things hook the top of my foot. They're so tight. I don't know, maybe if I need to go to 15 or what, but God knows you can't have 15.
The height. Oh,
I know, I can't. That's been my only claim to fame for the last almost 10 years. I'm talking about shit.
Okay.
Your incident has been updated.
Now you're just that guy.
That middle advertised guy.
That's good. You should like that feeling, though. Yeah. I like that feeling.
Now,
when I stand around to breathe, I'm like, man, that's so cool.
Oh, yeah.
I don't feel like a freak.
Now they're like, you know that tall guy on the 100th? I'm like, thanks.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm talking about. This guy can't be that nice.
He's on something. Dude, we grabbed a hold of him.
EMS didn't even care. They were like, well, yeah. I mean, he's like, he's sweating a lot, but he doesn't want to go to the hospital.
Yeah.
And I'm like, would you even, like, check his heart rate?
Because yeah.
His heart's probably kind of out of
his... Well, just trying to get him off that fence, man, was, it was not happening.
Like, hey, he's sweating profusely, and he's talking crazy. Like, and they're like, what year is this?
Liability,
baby. He was strong. He was strong. When he grabbed all that fence, I was like, well, I didn't see any other way at that point.
Yeah, I mean,
even when I hit him in the back, dude, he wasn't coming off the fence. So I had to go, like, lower. I went down to, like, here. And even still, when he got to the ground.
He's going to be so happy up
the road.
Oh, wow. Lottery.
I see that now.
That was safe.
Huh?
That's the way to show you. You
got safe.
That's not real either.
And look, he said, the doctor said he has to take a medication for it.
Dude, just from grabbing a hold of him and fighting with him on that fence, he's on something.
Yeah.
He was the strongest person I've ever met in my life.
I put that in
the
report.
I put that in the report. God, he was like, someone came for the leg too, and we still couldn't get him off. And then there was like two or three of us on one arm.
I'm the
clear that up while you're there,
too. That dude died yesterday.
don't know, dude. That was
like driving.
I think I'll do the tier three.
Driving home, I was like, yeah.
So he, we couldn't figure out if he got ejected or. Yeah, oh yeah, we couldn't figure out if he got ejected or he like got out of the vehicle. So we go up there, like you feel the seatbelt, and the seatbelt like felt like just by touching it, it was just gonna shatter under pure tension. The tension on it was like it was impossible. So he apparently was on 290 heading east towards Manor and decided, I guess, a semi was going to come over and he was going to try to overtake it, clipped it, and rolled his car about seven times.
The weight limit said about seven
times. Seven times.
You could count at least five big digits.
Now, the Toyota Avalon has an insane amount of airbags in it, like on the feet, on the side curtains, like headrests, like the whole thing. So I think he was just bouncing around it and then finally got ejected out the back window. And we got there, he's just sitting there. Like, he wasn't a serious life or anything, but he's just sitting there, he had, like, the concussion to end all concussion.
He was like, hey, man, you okay? Are you okay? And his dude was like...
Yeah, he had no idea what was going on.
But he was like...
Oh, dude, the car, like, it rolled so many times that the whole front end just got pretty much ripped off.
The
tire was about 20 feet away from it.
I found the gas fluid on, like, the third roll, buried into the dirt.
And it
under, like,
broke. It broke off. So that's how deep it went. How easy.
Yeah.
It's impressive. Yeah. Because we couldn't find the 18-wheeler. But everybody was like, yeah, he said it would take it. I thought the 18-wheeler hit it and just kept driving. But it sounds like he tried to take it over.
He thought the 18-wheeler was triple lane. And homeboy was trying. I guess he switched lanes probably kind of close to him. So he tried to, like, fly around him. And lift him as he was going around him.
Wow.
One way or the other.
Yeah, crazy.
That was the most intense crash we've ever seen.
But yeah, dude, he didn't roll into a green. He rolled.
Yeah.
He wasn't around here either, right?
No. We couldn't find his,
He got his name off a freaking brake check.
Yeah. And then I pulled up his iPhone and found, like, his name in there, but it was, like, in some Afghan name or something like that. Because all his, like, stuff inside of the CDs and stuff were, like, in Arabic or whatever.
He's alive. He's lucky he's alive.
Yeah, I hate car wrecks. That's the way I don't want to go, dude.
Yeah, if he's still alive. Well, he was wearing his seatbelt, which blew my mind that he's going to... If he comes out of that...
There's something to say about the airbag down.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was impressive for sure. Good old Toyota. They apparently make some pretty safe cars.
Your camera caught it?
Mine probably caught COVID.
Oh, mine did.
I bet you mine did.
Yeah, I bet you mine did, too.
Yours is right there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You should have a pretty good video of it.
Yeah, I mean, from like three different angles. I mean,
but just put the bookmarks there at the beginning and at the end of the article. And back in mind.
Yeah, some of that
people. We're all new seatbelts.
No details from you. Go ahead and do one just in case.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's paperwork. I want to make sure that it's paperwork. Okay.
Just in case.
You can do it. Well, that way, if they decide, that was our
report. A report's going to be no different. It's just a matter of marketing details, basically. That's what I want to know.
Different is what you do and what you do.
Okay. Easy enough.
Well, I'm going to do a logistic photo.
Yeah.
One of him, and then I guess one of those.
Who went for the legs? Is that you?
I
thought you went for the legs. They wouldn't do anything.
I mean, I tried.
That's why.
Oh, when you were standing up?
Yeah, and I tried the legs to him and to pry him off the thing like three or four times.
So I was like, all right.
We're going to have to tase this guy.
Who's shooting electricity through my handcuffs?
Dude, he popped his taser. Like, I hit him in the... No, I didn't want the spread. You just go for the third point. Like, I went there and then the lower back, thinking that it would just, like, arch his whole back and, like, let his legs go, or arms go, and he still wouldn't... don't even do anything. So I had to like go lower to like right down to their knee before they finally fell off the fence.
Stop shooting at you. I thought I wanted to call back on that McCain Alexander said you, same dude up there.
One of the things I think beat point that after they chime up. If you haven't already, can you dupe this call to the check call from the earlier on 14, please?
Why is it doing that?
Oh, he's clearly a danger to himself or others.
And he's probably been there before because the first thing he told me, one of the first things was, I don't want to go to a psychiatric. Well, the only thing we have is lifting.
Drive. shower and all that kind of stuff.
Probably enjoy the AST unit is about 10 minutes.